Very good evening, my dear students. This is your EVS teacher Monika Das. Today we are going to learn the lesson from tasting to digesting. Okay, here Jhumpa, Julan and their mother are in kitchen. When mother served dinner to both of them, Jhumpa ran to her mother and said, "Mother, I am not going to eat this bitter karela or bitter gourd." Jhumpa asked her mother to give her jaggery or roti instead of that. But her mother said she had eaten sugar and roti in the morning. Julan tasted it. "Don't you get bored of eating only one type of food? This is jaggery. I'm showing that to you, the jaggery. This is jaggery." And they had a long discussion. Then again, Jhumpa asked Julan, "Don't you get bored by licking the imli again and again?" Imli means that is tamarind. I'm showing that also here. Then Julan said to Jhumpa, "Let's play a game. You just close your eyes, then open your mouth. I will put something to eat in your mouth. You have to tell what is." Okay, this is the game. Okay, then Julan said he will put some food items in Jhumpa's mouth and Jhumpa have to guess the food with closed eyes. First, few drops of lemon juice she put. Then he could say, because of the taste of that food, the sour taste, so that she easily found that is lemon. Then next, she just put jaggery in her mouth. She easily find that because the sweet taste. Then just she brought the fried fish near to his mouth. Before tasting that, she could easily find this is fried fish because it has a strong smell. So we just not only taste our food, we can smell and we can tell the food name. Okay, then now she just bring bitter gourd japsi. She could easily find because bitter, salty, sour taste. We can recognize a food item not only by its taste but also its smell. We can easily find that. So my dear students, this is the concept. Julan's mouth started watering when she heard the word imli. When does your mouth water? List 5 things you like to eat and describe their taste. When I see the following things, my mouth waters. Things: taste, chocolate, sweet, chips, salty, ice cream, sweet, samosa, salty, raw, sour, mango. So my dear students, if you are eating imli at that time, if anyone is sitting opposite to you, his mouth will water. She will feel. Okay, then do you like only one kind of taste or different ones? Why? We like different kinds of taste. Only one type of taste can be boring because it is boring to taste one type of food. So mostly we will like to taste different kinds of taste. Julan put a few drops of lemon juice in Jhumpa's mouth. Do you think we can make out the taste with just a few drops? Yes, just a few drops of sour things are enough to make out the taste. If someone were to put a few seeds of aniseed on your tongue, what would be able to tell with your closed eyes? How? Because we can recognize some food items by their smell. Also fennel. See my dear students, how did Jhumpa make out the fried fish? Can you guess the name of certain things only by their smell without seeing or tasting them? What are these things? Jhumpa made out his fried fish by its smell. Has anyone ever told you to hold your nose before taking a medicine? Why do you think they tell you to do this? Yes, we can guess many things only by its smell, like fish, omelette, then samosa, bhaji, etc. Then, how did Zumba make out the fried fish? Can you guess the names of certain things only by their smell without seeing or tasting them? What are these? Already we discussed this question. The next, our sense of smell helps us to get complete taste of food. Closing our nose will somewhat mask the bitter taste of the medicine. So here they have given, has anyone ever told you to hold your nose before taking a medicine? Maximum, if you are taking medicine, maximum you will swallow that. You will not eat, you will swallow. So our sense of smell helps us to get complete taste of food. Closing our nose will somewhat mask the bitter taste of the medicine. Yes. Then the first question answer, how did Zumba make out the fried fish? Can you guess the name of certain things only by their smell without seeing, tasting them? What are these things? Zumba made out of fried fish by its smell. We can guess many things only by its smell, like fish, omelette, samosa, then etc. Okay. The next, close your eyes and tell. Collect a few food items having different kind of taste. Play a game with your friends like Zumba and Jolan. Tell your friends to taste the food and ask. Here they have given a picture, a long tongue. Here we are going to write the pot's name. Okay, see here, label the pots of the tongue. They have given that. Maximum this type of question they will ask in our examination. Then first, the tip of the tongue, by the help of that you can feel the sweet taste. Then above that you can feel the salty taste. Then next, above the salty taste, that place, middle of the tongue, you can feel the sour taste. Then near the throat place, you can feel the bitter taste. So my dear students, this is the place we can feel the taste. Tip of the tongue, sweety. Above that, salty. Middle of the tongue, sour taste. Near the throat, bitter taste. Okay, my dear students, they will ask that question, you have to mark the parts of the tongue. Okay. Then close your eyes and tell. Here they have given another one picture. So here clearly you can see, first tip of the tongue sweet, next salt, next sour, then bitter, then center part umami. What is umami, sir? Savory taste is one of the five basic tastes, together with sweetness, sourness, bitterness and saltiness. It has been described as savory and is characteristic of broths or cooked meats. Okay, my dear student, so five tastes you have to indicate the parts. Maximum this question will ask in your examination. Okay, then create a time, put some things to eat and other parts of our mouth under the tongue, on the lips, on the roof of the mouth. Did you get any taste that? No, we do not get any taste on other parts of the mouth. Yes. Use a clean cloth to wipe the front part of your tongue so that it's dry. Put some sugar or jaggery there. Could you taste anything? Why did this happen? No, we could not taste a thing. That is because there was no saliva there. What is saliva? When the food mixed with our saliva, then only we can get, then only we get its taste. See my dear students, I am showing the saliva's picture, but it's not good, so I will change this. Okay, just see it. Then you can see, stand in front of the mirror and look closely at your tongue. How does the surface look? Can you see any tiny bumps on the surface? Yes, these are called taste buds. Then my dear student, taste buds are the sensory organs that are found on our tongue and helps us to experience different tastes like sweet, salty, sour, bitter and savory. Okay, then if someone asks you to describe the taste of amla or cucumber, you might find it difficult to explain. Yes, it's exactly because cucumber, it has some watery taste, na? Then how you will find that? So it's difficult to explain. Then amla, first it will give some sour taste, then it will be sweety. Okay, then how would you describe the taste of this tomato, onion, senap and garlic? See, I'm showing on table. Tomato sweet and sour and juicy, onion pungent smell, then senap sweet with nice smell, then garlic bitter with pungent smell. Okay, so this is the table: tomato, sweet and sour and juicy, onion, pungent smell, then senap, sweet with nice smell, then garlic, bitter with pungent smell. Okay, this is they have asked that question, that's why I arranged this table. The next, when Jhumpa tasted some of things, she said, yes, my dear student, because if you taste chili, maximum you will say, because it's too spicy, that's why you will make this type of sound. Then, why do you think she may have eaten? Why don't you make sound that describes some taste? See, my dear student, if you are eating some sweet items, you will say, yummy. If you eat some noodles or porridge or ghee, you will say, slurp sound. Then, sour things like pickles, you will give some sounds. So, this is the sounds, expressions while you are eating some food. Okay, then, food enters our mouth. How it will enter? Teeth helps chew the food. Yes, exactly. Saliva mixes with the food and makes it soft. Yes, of course. Then, tongue helps us in four ways. Helps the food to move from left to right and right to left for proper chewing. Help to mix the saliva with the food. Pushes back the food for swallowing. Yes, this is food enters our mouth. These are the things will happen. Okay, the next. Each of you take piece of bread or roti or some cooked rice, put it in your mouth, chew 3 or 4 times and swallow it. Did the taste change as you had chewed it? Now take another piece. Did the taste change as you chewed it? See here, not much. It is almost the same. Put it in your mouth, chew 3 or 4 times and swallow it. Not much, it's almost the same. Then now take another piece or some rice and chew in 30 to 32 times. Yes, there is a change in taste. The food began to taste sweet. So, my dear student, has anyone at home told you to eat slowly and chew well so that the food digests properly? Why do you think they say this? Yes, my mother always tell me to eat slowly and to chew well. I think proper chewing is necessary for easier swallowing. It also helps to digest the food. Imagine you are eating something hard like a green guava. What kind of changes take place in it from the time you bite a piece and put it into a mouth to when you swallow it? See, when I bite off a piece of guava, it's hard and may taste somewhat bitter. After chewing for some time, it becomes soft and tastes sweet. The saliva makes the food soft and helps in its digestion. So, my dear student, what do you mean by digestion? To change food in your stomach so that it can be used by the body. See, think, what does the saliva in your mouth do? Saliva mix with the food in our mouth while chewing and makes it easy to digest. Then straight from the heart. See here, where do you think the food must going after you put in your mouth and swallow it? In the picture given here, draw the path of food through your body, share your picture with your friends, do all and have similar picture. See here, my dear students, first the food will go through the food pipe and then it will reach the stomach. So this lengthy pipe is called food pipe. The next one, this is stomach. Afterwards it will go to the stomach. Okay, the next, the digested food will go to the small intestine. Then the undigested food will go to this large intestine. Then the wasted items will go outside by the help of anus. Okay, my dear student. Digestive system, many organs work together and form a system. This is system help to digest our food. How do you feel when you are very hungry? How would you describe it? For example, sometimes we are jokingly say, I'm so hungry, I could eat an elephant. So that much I'm hungry, somebody will tell like that. Okay, maximum if you are hungry, your stomach will give some sound or sound. Maximum you can feel that. Okay, see here, when I'm hungry, some strange sound comes out of my stomach. My head also feels dizzy. Yes, then how do you come to know that you are hungry? I get a strong feeling to eat something. This is a strong feeling to show that I'm hungry. Then think, what would happen if you do not eat anything for 2 days? I think I do not eat anything for 2 days, I will become very weak and may fall sick. Then think next, Neetu was given a glucose strip. Neetu was very sick. Or here, think, what would happen if you do not eat anything for 2 days? Then what would you be able to manage without drinking water for 2 days? Where do you think the water that we drink goes? So this is what we are going to see. The story, Neetu was given a glucose strip. Why it's needed? Because if you are sick or vomiting or loose motion at that time, the water level will decrease. So you need some energy. That's why you need to take the glucose drip. Okay, my dear student. So see here, talk and discuss. Do you remember that class 4th you made a solution of sugar and salt? Neetu's father also made this and gave her. Why do you think this is given to someone who has vomiting and loose motion? Because already I told that the amount of water, salt and sugar decrease in the body, which can be dangerous. Salt and sugar solution is given to replenish the loss. Okay, then my dear students, second one question, have you heard the word glucose or seen written anywhere? Yes, I am showing some of the dappas. Just see it. This is the example. Have you heard the word glucose or seen written anywhere? Yes, my PT period, PT teacher will give this. Am I right? Yes. Then glucose strip. See here, glucose you will take from your mouth. Then glucose strip, they will directly go to your, it will go to you, it will mix with your blood. Okay, then if you take glucose, it will give energy little bit later, but if you are taking glucose strip, instantly you can get energy. Okay, then have you ever tasted glucose? How does it taste? Tell your friends. Yes, I have tasted glucose. It tastes sweet. Then have you or anyone in your family been given a glucose strip? When and why? Tell the class about it. Maybe you have seen glucose strip being given to grandparents, mostly because they will fall sick maximum. Neetu's teacher used to tell the girls to have glucose while playing hockey. Why do you think she did this? When she play outdoor games, we sweat a lot, which result in loss of water, salt and sugar from our body. To replenish the loss, we should have glucose solution. Yes, this is a very nice. Yes, really. Look at Neetu's picture and describe what is happening. How is the glucose strip being given? See here, there is the glucose bottle. From there, a thin pipe is there. By the help of that, the glucose will come. Then next, it will go, it will mix directly the patient blood. Okay, then she can get instant energy. Okay, story, a stomach with a window. So they have given a story, you just read that. But here we will we can see what will happen at last. The doctor Bhimant, he has taken because he saw a soldier with injured stomach. Okay, so from there the doctor taken a liquid juice. Then he wanted to see what would happen to a food item kept in the glass field with it. Would it get digested on its own? So he collected some of the stomach juice and he kept in a bottle. Then he just checked that, because he just taken the digestive juice from the stomach. And then 8:30 a.m. he put 20 tiny pieces of boiled fish in 10 milliliters of the juice. Okay, see my dear student, he has taken digestive juice from the stomach of the patient. Then he just kept in a bottle. Then 8:30 he just poured some boiled fish in 10 milliliter of juice. Then he kept the glass at the same temperature at the out of our stomach, about 30 degrees Celsius. When he checked at 2 p.m., he found that all the pieces food had dissolved. Dissolved mean digested. Okay. Then he just then Bhiman took some liquid juice and he wanted to see what will happen. Then finally he found that because all the items were dissolved. Then he just did another experiment. He just take unboiled milk. Then in the stomach it is digesting within 2 hours 15 minutes. Then he just put the same food in the glass with digestive juice. In that area, it will be dissolved within 4 hours 45 minutes. Okay, but in our stomach, it got first it's digesting, but at the same time, if it is in a glass bottle, it will take a time. No, it will take long time. Okay, to do that. Okay, then what will happen? Our stomach churns the food to digest it. What is the meaning churns? Maximum in our home, our mother will take buttermilk from the milk. Na, so she just grind that, then she just churns the food very fast. So in our stomach also, it's a violent force is happening. So our stomach churns the food to digest it. Okay. Then here I have given the stomach picture. Then acidity. Why acidity is happening in our stomach? If you didn't take food properly, then the acid, because the doctor took some acid juice from the stomach, na, that acid will increase. So the acidity, he will be affected by acidity. Okay, this is acidity. You have to take food properly. Then journey of food. Food enters our mouth, we taste and chew it. Then food enters to the stomach through food pipe. Then food gets mixed with digestive juice. Stomach churns and food is digested. Digested food gives energy to the body in the form of glucose. Then undigested food passes through small intestine and large intestine. Undigested food is passed out of the body in the form of waste. Then, my dear student, this is journey of food. Okay, what will happen if we eat too less or eat too much? See here, they have given two story. This is Rashmi, then this is Kailas. Rashmi eat less food, that's why she is looking like this. Then Kailas is taking too much food, so he is appearing in this manner, fat and flappy. Okay, see here, Rashmi, the poor people will take less food, that's why they are having this type of pot belly. Okay, just see him, you can understand what how it will be pot belly. Okay, then Kailas is eating junk food, that's why he is appearing fat and flappy. Okay, then my dear student, Rashmi is too poor to afford a proper meal, that is why she could eat only one roti in a day. Then do you think Kailas would like games and sports? Maximum he will not like, because he is very fat and he is looking like flappy. So that's why we could understand he didn't like sports. Then what do you understand by proper food? Adequate and nutritious food according to one body need make the proper food. See here, Rashmi is not getting adequate amount of food and Kailas is taking too much amount of junk food, which is the body does not need. Okay, why do you think that the food of Rashmi and Kailas was not proper? Because she is taking more, sorry, she is taking less, he is taking more. Okay, see here, talk with your grandparents or elderly people and find out what they eat and what work they did when they were your age. Maximum, my grandparents used to eat rice, dal, green vegetables, milk and lot of fresh fruits. They used to do lot of physical activities. They used to walk 2 miles to go to school. They used to play games which involve lot of physical activities. The modern times have changed. We do eat rice, dal and vegetables, but we also take many junk food. I go to school by school bus. Major part of my free time is spent sitting on the sofa watching TV or playing computer games. We do less amount of physical activities. Am I right? Yes. Now think about yourself, your daily activities and daily diet. Maximum we are going school by bus, that's why maximum we are spending the time to sitting in sofa or in chair. Am I right? Are these similar or different from what your grandparents did and eat? Already we have seen in this paragraph, they eat rice and dal and green vegetables. Okay, then proper food, every child's right. Yes, exactly, it's right. Proper food, every child's right. In our country, every child should have the proper food. This is very important. See, I'm showing some picture. This is these people, these children didn't get proper food. Why? because you should not waste the food. If you waste the food, then our country people will appear in this manner. He couldn't get food, okay? And then you have to mind this word, proper food, every child's right. So please, my dear student, don't waste the food. Then, do you know any child who does not get enough to eat in whole day? What are the reasons for this? Children living in slums or backwards on road do not get enough food. To eat because they are very poor to buy food. Yes. Have you ever seen a godown where a lot of grain has been stored where? Yes, I have seen the godown because I am showing that picture. This is the godown. Maximum food items, grain items will be stored there. Yes. Then what we have learnt? Why can you not taste food properly when you have a cold? Our sense of smell helps us to get complete taste of our food. When we have cold, our nose is blocked, which blocks the sense of smell, so we are unable to taste the food properly. If we were to say the digestion begins in our mouth, how would you explain? Digestion begins in our mouth. Salivary glands present in our mouth secrete saliva. See, this is salivary glands. Okay, I'm showing the picture. Saliva contains digestive juice which helps to break down complex sugars into simple sugars. Then thus it can be said that digestion begins in the mouth. Okay, my dear students, then this is the questions. What food items do you like eat? I like to eat all types of food items. So I am showing the question and answers, just you can copy in your notebook. Okay, my dear student, really I hope today's session is will be very useful to you. So you just see the question and answer, then you can copy this. Thank you, students. Bye bye.